But I mean, I'm not happy about that, to be honest.
I'm a bit worried about that quite a bit. I mean, it's not normal.
It's not, no.
It feels like it's gonna be Far Cry New Dawn all over again.
You know what, I'm going to give them a little bit of credit. We don't know anything for sure. You saw the things that pre-alpha build. So that's very early stage gameplay. So it could look a lot better, more fluid.
The problem is, as soon as you have so long, because I make games, I can tell you, when it's pre-alpha gameplay, it's a very, very slim chance of changing anything. The change so it's as big as, like, going from RPG to just normal Batman Arkham is going to be huge.
Yeah, I mean, look, I still have to see more, to be honest.
Yeah.
Like, that's the main thing. Like, people are making judgments too fast from what I'm seeing. Like, you know, I get that people want Batman to be in it, but, you know, I think we can survive a game without him. And plus, we might be able to take him down in the Suicide Squad game.
When do you think that's set? Do you think that's set before or after?
I don't even know if it's in the same universe, to be honest with you.
I think they are, because I think that's what I think saying. Oh, we don't want Batman in our game, because this and that.
Maybe. You never know. I don't know.
It was very similar to that in a film where everyone thought Batman was dead. But I can't remember what it's called, Batman and Robin, was that? No, Batman vs. Robin.
Probably.
And they all thought he was dead, and then he turned out to be alive, but he was mind controlled at the end. I wonder.
Right, that's.
I wonder if we'll get
that's,
that last.
That's what I'm thinking about. When I first saw that whole trailer, my first thought was, he's probably not dead.
No, it was too much of a cash cow. It's like Captain America in the Avengers game. He's definitely not dead.
Right.
I mean, I bet you will fight him in this game, or so.
Maybe, yeah.
That would be cool. So, what did you think of the characters?
I thought some of the designs were kind of weird. Like, the way Barbara looked, I didn't like.
It's so purple, wasn't it? I don't know that's
yeah.
Cool. Like, how...
It wasn't the purple that bothered me. It was more like all the lines around it and stuff.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, though. I'm quite happy with Red Hood was in it, then. He was quite a cool character.
Oh, me too. I heard he wasn't going to be in it. Like, I heard they were going to kind of take away from him, but now I'm really glad.
I heard that he was going to be a PlayStation exclusive. I'm praying to God that he isn't.
Who, Red Hood?
Yeah, because there was, like, rumors about him being a PlayStation exclusive.
Oh. I would have hated that.
Yeah, I would have lost my shit. I'll tell you what, though. Do you think they're going to allow kill him now? Because unless he's using rubber bullets, he's literally shooting people in the face.
No, this is... Yeah, you're going to be able to... Yeah, Red Hood, yeah, he's going to be able to kill. Sure.
Sorry, I don't know what happened. I sort of lagged out.
That's fine, yeah.
So
I'm not focusing right now because I'm looking at the chat. Most of the chat is pissed.
What, on the FanDome or Twitter?
Yeah. If Red Hood shoots, if Red Hood shoots people in the face, it won't be rubber bullets.
No, plus I think even if it was rubber bullets, that would still have a good chance of killing you.
It could, yeah. I wish they had told us more, though, like, all this time, and, like, I know we got gameplay and a reveal trailer, but I kind of wanted them to talk more about, like, whether, like, the gameplay aspects and whether it had the Nemesis system. It kind of reminds me of Watch Dogs Legion.
Actually, yeah, that's a fair point. I mean, I can see what you mean there, actually. I wish there was, like, more hacking in it, now that you say that, because Batman hats everything.
Yeah.
Apparently they can break bones, and
There's some what?
rubber bullets are slightly less lethal than the natural bullet, but can still cause injuries such as broken bones, blindness, disabilities, and death.
Yeah, rubber bullets can still kill you. Alright, well, I'm actually okay, I'm gonna I kinda wanna watch this upcoming panel like about the Sandman. So I think
Okay.
I'm ahead for now.
Yeah, it's nice talking to you.
Alright, you too, man. We
Yeah.
can talk later.
Yep. Yeah.
Bye, bro.
And he said, here we are. And he gave me some Alan Moore. You know, he gave me V for Vendetta and Watchmen and Swamp Thing and Constantine and Sandman. And I remember reading the first few Sandmans and it just sort of, well, I mean, it did literally change my life. It kind of, it gave me, it sort of both reinforced what I was already interested in, but opened doors to whole universes for the rest of my life. I mean, it created my taste, really, I suppose. It led me to finding out about Joseph Campbell and comparative mythology and Carl Jung and I mean, all kinds of stuff. It just blew my mind. And certain things really stayed with me. And one of those things was the character of Lucifer when you first meet him early on in the story and that kind of young Bowie look. That image had really stayed with me. So when I came to do Lucifer, that was there at the back of my mind. And I loved the idea of someone who looks very angelic. I mean, he is an angel. He's the fallen angel. And that young Bowie with the curly blonde hair is very angelic and sort of chirpy. Hello, you know, and it sort of, it takes you by surprise. You're expecting Lucifer to be Lucifer. And of course, you don't have to, it's like, hello, Dream, how are you? And I love that idea of sort of surprising the audience and pulling the rug out from under their feet, which Neil is so brilliant at. And of course, the first thing I ever saw to do with the Sandman was the cover of Preludes and Nocturnes, the Dave McKean art. And even from that, I knew I was entering into a whole other world. And then, of course, getting to know Dave many years later was a bit of a dream come true.
He is such a singular talent and such a singular vision. It was weird with Sandman. I think we had this huge fight on our hands right in the very beginning when we told DC that the title character Morpheus would not be on every cover. I remember them coming back going, but how will people know this is Sandman? And we said, well, because the word Sandman will be on every cover. And having lost that battle, they never fought again. They were like, okay, well, obviously we don't know what this thing is. And they're doing things that break all the rules because you have to have the character on the cover and they aren't. So they're just doing their thing. And it really was Dave having that fight. And also around Sandman 9, Dave refusing to be fired. Karen Berger fired him. He was in New York and she said, we don't have time for you to do any more Sandman covers. Then he said to me, I've been fired. And I said, what are you going to do? He said, well, I'm going to spend the next 2 days painting the next 8 Sandman covers and then I'm going to send them over to her and I'll see what she says. And that's what he did. He just made the rest of the Doll's House covers. Amazing. He did all the covers and sent them over. And what was she going to do? They were brilliant.
Of course, I'd spent a fair amount of time with Neil fairly recently when we did Good Omens together. So I got used to Neil being on the other side of the camera and close to me, which I liked. But he's sort of creeping ever closer, like a game of grandma's clock. Is that what it's called? Where, you know, every time I look around, he's not behind the camera now. Now he's actually standing next to me in the recording studio narrating the damn thing. I mean, if he gets any closer, we'll have to have an operation to be separated.
I love the fact that I get to work with Michael. Michael and I have been friends since 2010. And we've been working together since 2017. And just, I get to just admire him as an actor more and more. And the very, very peculiar feeling of having my friend Michael standing next to me in the studio and opening his mouth and this voice that basically belongs to David Bowie playing Lucifer.